Basically, you are looking at the people of Blackpool, the people at home. You will be looking at the next UWA Heavyweight Champion of the World. And that's all I gotta say on the matter.
You wanna see some heavy stuff? We're gonna be here.
Hello and welcome to this week's UWA Wrestling Rampage. I'm Dan Belenka, and in this hour we'll see the anarchist Doug Williams in his first UWA title defense against Steve Linsky's monster, the Highlander, Drew McDonald. Also in this hour we'll see the man that Drew McDonald won that title shot from. Danny Royal is here and will be in action. Shane and Murphy take on the Death Squad, but first we'll hear from the UWA television champion, Flyin' Phil Powers. 2 weeks ago, the television title match ended in a controversial no contest when Kerry Cabrera sealed his newfound alliance with challenger Stevie Knight with a brutal chair shot. Once the dust had cleared the following week, Stevie Knight demanded and was granted a rematch, but with the following stipulation. Paul Sloan will be the special guest referee. While Stevie Knight has been arguing that this is unfair, Paul Sloan is, after all, Phil Powers' protege, and Stevie Knight has been lobbying hard to add a stipulation of his own.
Sasha, my love, listen, I know you hold a lot of stroke here in the UWA. You've got a bit of pull with the management here in the UWA, yeah? Okay, listen, me and Carrie, we've put our collective minds together, we've been thinking. Paul Sloan is the referee of my title match, as you know, with Phil Powers, the return title match. Now, as we all know, it's been plugged on TV week after week after week. Old conk, Paul Sloan, he was trained by Phil Powers. Now, me and Kerry are a little bit worried about the fact Paul Sloan could disqualify me to save Phil Powers' title. You must agree with me there, Sasha. It's quite possible, is it? Don't say anything, just don't say anything, just listen. So what we were thinking was, if you could just have a word with the management, you know, use your valuable pull, you know, just
whatever
to make it,
takes.
You know, whatever it takes, just to make it a no disqualification match. We've got faith in you, love. I'm going to leave it in your hands. We know you can do it. All right? Okay, love. All right, don't say anything yet. Just leave it. I'll expect the match to be no disqualification. Thank you, Sasha. Thank you. Thank you, love. Thank you once again. Thank you. Come on, Kerry.
Well, Stevie Knight, they're pushing hard to add a no disqualification stipulation to his rematch for the television title against Phil Powers. We'll find out just what is the response from Sorsha and the UWA officials right after this interview with the television champion, Flyin' Phil Powers.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome the UWA television champion, Flyin' Phil Powers!
Welcome, wrestling fans, to an absolutely jam-packed show. I'm Ross the Boss Gordon, and alongside me in the commentary booth, a man who's as strong as an ox and almost as smart, Mr. Steve Morgan.
Ross, it's lovely to have you back here, and viewers, if you're wondering where he's been, I can tell you, Ross the Boss has been on the run! And we're glad to offer you asylum here on the UWA. And
well,
back for a corker of a show!
Well, asylum isn't the word I look for sitting next to you.
You should be in one.
Phil, we saw in your last defense against Hot Stuff Stevie Knight that you retained your championship belt under somewhat controversial circumstances. We would say...
Okay, let's stop that nonsense right now, okay? Kerry Cabrera, Hot Stuff Stevie Knight, have got it into their heads that Stevie Knight is somehow the UWA television champion. Well, let's put it right, plain and simple, right here, right now. Stevie Knight, if you think you're the UWA television champion, we'll come on down to this ring right now, pal, and we'll fight it out for this championship. Come on, I want to see ya. Let's fight it out right now.
Woo! Get the madam. I mean, what's his argument? He was beaten. He was pinned by Stevie Knight, And yet here he is, moaning in the ring!
He was only pinned because Kerry Cabrero interfered with a chair.
Well, here he comes! You don't know what you're talking about. Here he comes!
Excuse me, Mr. Ignorant.
The soon-to-be crowned TV champion.
The only way Steve Knight could pin Phil Powers was by using outside interference, and the match, rightfully so, was ruled a no contest. And Stevie Knight and Phil Powers looks like they're going to get it off.
Yes!
But no, Phil disposes of Stevie Knight well over the top rope, crashing down into the hard floor. But look, here comes
Kerry Cabrero. Phil Powers has bitten off more than he can chew.
Kerry goes for the flatliner, but it's reversed into a hurricanrana. And here comes Paul Sloan. He's making his way down to ringside. What's going to go? He counts a three
It's a three.
Well, it wasn't a match, but you could say if it was, Kerry Cabrero would have been defeated.
Let's have another look at that, because I can't believe what I've seen here.
Cabrero goes for the flatliner powerbomb, but Phil Powers acrobatically reverses it into a hurricanrana.
Well, you're going to have to beat the flyer Phil Powers. And quite frankly, son, I just can't see that happening.
You're going to end up eating your words, Powers. You're going to end up eating your words.
He was speaking to you, Steve Morgan. He was saying he can't see Stevie Knight beating Flying Phil Powers for the television title. And quite frankly, neither can I. And of course, wrestling fans, next week on UWA Wrestling Rampage, you'll see Flying Phil Powers defend his television title against Hot Stuff Stevie Knight, with Paul Sloan, Phil's protege, as the referee. But today, still to come, we're going to see Doug Williams put his world title on the line against the Highlander, Drew McDonald. But first, let's hear comments from the lovely Shorsha.
That's where we're going now to find out if that fight will be a non-disqualification competition. I hope so.
UWA committee have decided not to grant Stevie Knight a no DQ match. However, we have decided that the title belt can change on a disqualification. Therefore, guest referee Paul Sloan cannot make his decisions lightly.
Certainly none of those decisions Paul Sloan will have to make will be taken lightly. I'm sure Paul Sloan will call the action down the line as fairly as he has been trained by
Let's
Phil
hope
Powers.
So. Let's hope so. We'll find out next week. But right now we await the arrival in the ring of Danny Royal, British Beef.
And his opponent, he stands at 6'1". He weighs a train-stuffing 245 pounds. He's British Beef, Danny Royal.
Danny Royal, in my opinion, one of the most talented individuals in the Ultimate Wrestling Alliance and a personal favourite of mine.
Yeah, but you think with all that money, he'd buy a new pair of trunks, wouldn't you, Ross?
The Beef Man was very unfortunate a few weeks ago to lose to the Highlander Drew McDonald. He was in that number one contender match for a shot at the UWA World title. But of course, we're going to see the match between the Highlander Drew McDonald and Doug Williams, our current champion, later on the show. A match I'm extremely excited about.
I can't wait for it either. And I tell you this, Doug Williams has made a mistake in making an enemy of Steve Linsky. Doug, of course, sacked him in, which was a very unkind fashion a few weeks ago now. Steve Linsky was more than a manager to Doug Williams. He was a mentor. He was everything. He built up that young man's career. And now Doug Williams will rue the day he ever did that when he steps into that ring to defend his UWA heavyweight title against Drew McDonald.
Well, you obviously think it was a mistake of Doug dropping Steve Linsky. Talking of mistakes,
of course it was.
It may have been a mistake for Justin Richards to get in the ring with the very technically sound Danny Royal.
Well, it doesn't look like it now. It looks as though Danny Royal is suffering.
I don't think so. Look at that great British wrestling ability being used there as Danny Royal hits a big power slam. Now he heads towards the top rope, but a drop kick brings him back down onto the canvas. I think these two are guys who we're going to have to watch for in the future. We haven't seen Justin Richards much before in the UWA, but certainly everything Danny Royal has done in the UWA so far has been impressive. He's just been a little bit unlucky in not getting the win-loss record of, say, someone like Doug Williams, who has a very impressive win-loss record, but that could all change tonight when he takes on Drew.
Well, Danny Royal was no competition for Drew McDonald.
That's not true.
He was no competition.
That is not true. It took an exposed turnbuckle to let Danny Royal lose.
If you don't know what you're doing with an exposed turnbuckle. I've seen men shed tears.
Look at the power in the ring exhibited by Danny. The beef man there used a giant suplex. Did you hear it as it crashed down onto the canvas? That's going to have hurt Justin Richards. And now what's he going for here? This is another patented move of his. The crowd, listen to the crowd. It's the Beefman press slam. And look at the pain on Justin Richards' face. Danny Royal must have the match almost won now. I think it's in the bag. Richards is slow to get back to his feet. Danny Royal is sending a message not only to Drew McDonald, not only to Steve Linsky, but to every wrestler in the UWA that he wants a piece of them, and he can get a piece of them
by using the skills he's using just now. That's not the message he's sending them. The message he's sending them is he needs new trunks.
Why does he need new trunks? He's showing that he's proud of his country. A great spinning powerbomb there. But it's not good enough to get the 1, 2, 3. Danny seemed a little bit cocky there, almost playing to the crowd. And what's he doing? This is it. This is his trademark move. It's the beef bomb. That's it. That'll get the pinfall. No one kicks out from that. 1, 2, 3. Danny Royal sending a message around the UWA with a very convincing win over Justin Richards here tonight.
Still to come on UWA Wrestling Rampage, the UWA title is on the line. The anarchist Doug Williams must face the Highlander Drew McDonald. But up next, Shane and Murphy take on the Death Squad.
The sizzling summer soccer rolls on with Glasgow Rangers versus Finnish champions FC Haka. It's a football feast, Thursday at 9.
I wish they'd take their smell with them.
I'll get the Febreze.
Febreze is a new way of getting rid of odours on fabrics.
I spray my curtains, my cushions, my car seats. Nothing gets rid of smoky smells like this does.
Febreze doesn't cover up one smell with another. It finds the bad odours trapped in fabrics and gets rid of them safely.
My couch. It's even safe on this.
It'll soon smell clean and fresh again.
Once it's dry, the smell's gone. For good.
Febreze.
The cloakroom. It's a kid's room.
Next to the fabric softeners.
Febreze gets bad smells out of fabrics for good.
Well, you won't go in the washing machine.
Direct Cash can offer you up to £1,000, money which you pay back in small monthly instalments. You can draw on your personal reserve whenever you need some extra cash. So, for an amount of £1,000, you would pay back the minimum of £50 a month. That's an APR of just 19.5. And with Direct Cash, you can spend your money on whatever you choose. Call today and you could receive your money within a matter of days. Call 0800 301 301 now to receive this free information pack. That's 0800 301 301.
Take a fun look into your future with the help of the tarot cards. Call 08962 626201 and let the cards help guide you in all aspects of your life. If you're more interested in your love life, call 08962 626202 for a relationship reading. Or why not consult the stars to find out just who is your ideal astrological partner? Call now on 08962 626203.
Don't miss the cab or OneTel's lowest rates ever. Register now for cheap long-distance calls from your home or business phone. Only 3p a minute to the USA, 5p to Australia and 6p a minute to New Zealand. Plus, fantastic low rates to Canada, Belgium, Italy and loads more 24 hours a day and 7 days a week. So call 0800 634 1855 and register today. Don't miss OneTel's lowest rates ever.
You tell your friends about OneTel.
Tonight at 8:30.
So you saw somebody touch your wife's behind.
Uh-huh.
And you didn't say anything.
I'm just not much of a talker.
Judge Judy, tonight at 8:30.
Welcome back, people of Britain, for UWA Wrestling Rampage. You join us now with Shane and Murphy about to enter the ring to take on the Death Squad. The winner of this contest will get a title shot.
And coming to the ring first, standing 6 feet two and 6 feet five and a half, they have a combined weight of 470 pounds. They are Shane and Murphy.
Here we have the chalk and cheese combination, the arrogance here, as we saw a few weeks ago, when Alex Shane decided to get an opposing competition with a ringside bodybuilder, and he was, well, he suffered for that with that punch which knocked him to the ground, causing their team to lose the match against Too Far Gone.
We all would have that the best tag team in the UWA. So why is it that week after week we wrestle without getting shut up? We wrestle without getting a shot at the tag team titles. Shut it! Every tag team, you've got the Death Squad, you've got Too Far Gone, and we're Shane and Murphy. Now, what kind of a tag team name is that? So, it becomes apparent to me that we need a really nice tag team name for us to get a shot.
Dumb and Dumber.
So, I think, seeing as I'm a man of action, and I like action films, my favourite genre of all Van Damme film is called Double Impact. So, from now on, Shane and Murphy are known as Double Impact. And the second thing, it becomes very apparent to me, obviously by looking at me you can tell that I have good looks, I have charisma, I have a great body, and I have great wrestling talent. And then look at this guy. Leon, you're fat, you're out of shape, and to be quite honest, you let down the team. But don't worry, Leon, don't worry, because I know the secret to make us tag team champions, and I've got it right here in this bag. Leon, the thing you are missing is without a doubt, a pair of PVC pants like mine.
Don't go down that route, Leon! You'll never come back!
And we're going straight to the top of the UWA.
Before you know it, you'll be performing at the Vauxhall Tavern on a Friday night! The what, Steve? The what?
And sit down, shut up, and
never you mind.
I can probably guess what it is, and I know why you know what it is.
Shut your face, you!
And hearing that song can only mean one thing. It's time for the entrance of one of the most popular teams here in the Ultimate Wrestling Alliance, if not the most popular team. Individually, they are Iron Duke Lynch and the Hammer Mark Meyer. They are the Death Squad.
And coming to the ring now, preceded by one half of the Tiny Yozlana, they are recognized as the most destructive tag team. They are the Death Squad!
The original tag team champions here in the UWA. They got their own belts and they were recognized by the UWA as their belts could be.
They were lovely belts as well that they made.
And these belts are now the official UWA tag team titles.
But of course, those belts didn't remain in the possession of the Death Squad for long.
Oh no, in a match which saw the Death Squad take on Big Papa T and the high-flying Jody Flash. Here we see Big Papa T interfering into the contest when he wasn't the legal man, which let Jody Flash hit a springboard spinning DDT for the one, the two, and the three to see the team of Jody Flash and Big Papa T capture the tag team titles. But the following week, Big Papa T abandoned Jody, choosing to run after Frank, the man
the
that we don't...
The mysterious Frank!
The man that I certainly don't know a lot about, which saw Too Far Gone take out Jody Flash, and yet again, we had a title change, which saw Too Far Gone become the tag team champions.
I really don't know about Double Impact. I really don't. But tell you what, we just thought of a good tag team name for both of you. What about Dumb and Dumber?
Have they been listening to you, Steve?
They certainly do. They're wise boys, these ones.
Not if they've been listening to you.
Right, well, cheer up, boys, because I don't know if some people will remember from a week or two ago, but we lost a belt. We're going to get them back. But we've got a little bit of a bonus so we can get some viable tag teams to come against us, which is this. Some people remember us coming down to ringside and bike. Well, fire regulations say we're not allowed to come down with it again, but I assure you it's our bike.
It's not
so,
like the death squad to respect the rules.
The keys and the paperwork. As you can see, Mr. Cameraman, for the said vehicle. Now, tonight, and in every other match that we have, that machine is up for grabs. So as well as your wages, boys, you take on the bike and anyone else who beats us. So there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for work.
Viewers, I can tell you how much Iron Duke loves that bike. It is his pride and joy. Much like one half of the China girls there. But to put it on the line like that must mean that these boys are serious about getting back those tag team belts.
They're either serious about getting the belts back or they're perhaps not taking the challenge of Double Impact seriously.
But would you take them seriously with a name like that?
I certainly would. They're fine grapplers as we see the hammer lock up and go into an arm bar on Leon Murphy.
Leon Murphy looks like an escaped convict.
Leon Murphy looks like a legitimate hard man, something you are not.
Oh, yeah? Don't cross words with me, boy.
The teams in the UWA, in fact, all the wrestlers in the UWA are trained highly professional athletes. And I'm looking here at the team of the Death Squad and their entourage they normally bring with them, the Tiny Girls. There's only one Tiny Girl with them. I wonder what's up there. Do you know anything, Steve?
Yeah, I've done a runner with the other one. Ha ha ha! Ho ho!
Yeah, attached to a barge pole. That was for her benefit, of course.
Thank you, Ross.
Here we have Duke Lynch now. Taking to bits, Alex Shane. He sends Shane off the ropes and hits a big clothesline. Alex Shane stands 6'5". And now, once again, set off the ropes, and Leon Murphy and Alex Shane using some great double team tactics there to take down the Death Squad. As I've said before, regardless of a wrestler's size, and regardless of his strength, if you take him down onto the mat, you take away those advantages. However, Alex Shane certainly doesn't need to do that because he's a big enough man. As we see now, a huge double suplex on giant Duke Lynch.
Well, as I said earlier, the winners of this contest will get a title shot, and we will hear from the tag team champs Too Far Gone after this match on their reaction on the outcome of this battle royale. Now, Ross, I heard a rumor you may have some information about live events in the UWA. Can you give me any information?
I can't tell you anything at the moment.
You what?
What I can tell you, fans, is that you can watch it on TV, and yes, it is exciting on TV, but it's 1,000 times more exciting to see it live, in the flesh, in the arena. You've got to savor the atmosphere in a way you just can't do sitting on your couch at home, swigging down a bottle of 26p cheap cola. You've got to come to an event, and we'll tell you more information on live events for the UWA, where you can catch all the action live in the next part of the show.
I would go along with that. Viewers, you haven't sampled the joys of live wrestling until you have sat there in the arena and smelt Ross the Boss's BO, because it's a moment you'll treasure.
I'm a clean person, unlike you. But speaking of clean action, we're seeing some very good action in the ring at the moment. And fans, I can give you a little bit of a scoop here. We can give you a little bit of a scoop. The winners of this match will be in the hotline tonight, so join us. The number's coming up at the end of the show. Join us in the hotline to hear from the winners of this match. And look, the Tiny Girl is distracting Alex Shane. He seemed to have the match won, but the Tiny Girl distracted him. And now, watch this.
He ought to start thinking with his head, that boy, and stop thinking with his...
Yes, well, a tombstone pile driver there will just stop him thinking, full stop. As Duke Lynch now appears to have the match won, and they hit the Sheffield Hammer for the one, the two, and the three.
Bingo!
And Leon Murphy at ringside doesn't look happy.
Here he goes, finish him off, Mark!
They
always like to
there.
Make sure that the job, if it's worth doing, it's done properly. Stop picking your nose, boy in the front row.
Why wasn't Leon Murphy helping out Alex Sheen yet?
Well, you may ask that, Ross, but all I know is we are left with two worthy victors in the shape of the Death Squad.
Wow. Yes. Well, it looks like the paperwork and the keys are coming home with us again tonight. Here we go.
Too far gone. If you're watching, get ready. Because what we give to them is nothing. And I repeat, nothing compared to what we're going to do to you.
The Death Squad is always making waves with each appearance in the UWA. And fans, coming up soon, a commercial break in which I'll go out and find information about live events.
Would you, Ross? That would be most helpful.
But what's going on here? There seems to be dissent between Shane and Murphy. Double impact.
Are they arguing about PVC pants? That's the question.
But we're going to go to the current World Tag Team Champions in the UWA. It's Steve Morocco, Paul Terrell, Too Far Gone.
So, Paul, what is this with Dane Erickson on the show tonight?
Steve, I just don't know what's going on. Dane Erickson, who is this guy? You know, he's a nobody. The UWA, I mean, they're forcing us to defend our titles against people that aren't worthy of a title shot. You know, we're the UWA Tag Team Champions. We should be getting treated better than this. We deserve more respect. I'm taking on a singles match against Dane Erickson. You know, I mean... I'd like to think it would be a warm-up, Steve, but...
Probably will be.
It's not even going to be a warm-up. Dane Erickson, this match is coming up shortly. For you, it's going to come round too soon, and you're going to wish it never even happened.
The sizzling summer soccer rolls on with Glasgow Rangers versus Finnish champions FC Harker. It's a football feast, Thursday at 9.
Talk to exciting new people in the phone bar now. Call 09066 144 166 and join up to 210 callers online now. That's 09066 144 166.
Wherever you are and whatever you're doing, get yourself down to the house party and talk live one-to-one with the coolest guests around. Come on in and join us on 09066 140 150. You know it makes sense.
I'm telling you, they should play what they used to. They should go a 4-4-2 every time.
No, we've got to use wing-backs so that we can get extra support to midfield.
Well, United and Arsenal aren't doing too badly.
Yeah, but at international level, you lose the ball once, you spend the rest of the time chasing shadows.
Call me old-fashioned, but I still say fast, attacking football in a 4-4-2 formation is what frightens the world's best.
Yeah, well, that might work all right at club level, but obviously not on the big stage.
Call Top Football 365 with me, Andy Gray, on 09062 140 140.
This is an appeal from Oxfam to ask if you can give £2 a month to help some of the world's poorest people. Give a man a fish and he'll feed himself for just a day. But give him the means to catch his own fish and he'll be able to feed himself and his family for a whole lifetime. A cup of water might quench your thirst for an hour, but give £2 a month to Oxfam and you'll help her dig a well, giving her children safe, clean water, protecting them from diseases which kill thousands every day. A bowl of grain could feed her for a few days, but £2 a month can provide seeds and tools, enabling people to grow food for themselves and for future generations. People in the third world don't want to live on handouts. All they want is the opportunity to work themselves out of poverty and the chance to live dignified and independent lives. With your help, we can do so much more So please, ring 0800 33 88 33 and give just £2 a month or whatever you can. That's 0800 33 88 33. Thank you.
This week on Agony.
Will Maria be able to keep a secret?
Where's these other two's morals and where's their brains?
Can Louise keep two men on the go? Emma's feeling broody, but will Neil play dad?
What a complete rat.
Will Justine's man clean up his act? Greg's feeling gorgeous, but could his girlfriend be jealous?
Greg, you're a dink.
Delve into the nation's dilemmas with Agony all this week.
Welcome back, fans. Once again, I'm Ross DeVos Gordon alongside Steve Morgan. And during the break, as promised, I've been doing a little bit of investigating.
What can you tell us, Ross?
Well, live event news for the Ultimate Wrestling Alliance. I can tell you the next show will be in the area of the M25.
Oh, come on, that could be anywhere. Surely you must know more.
Well, I suppose I can tell you it will be a homecoming of sorts.
Sounds interesting. Sure you can't tell us any more?
Well, I can tell you it's going to be in about the next 4 weeks, and I'll keep you posted.
Thank you, Ross.
And here we have Too Far Gone coming out. But of course, it's only going to be Paul Terrell taking part in this match. This is Paul Terrell's first singles match in the UWA. You know, within the last few weeks, we've seen an attitude change from Too Far Gone. They've gone from being nice guys, from liking the fans, to really not giving a damn anymore. And look at that, they don't even have respect for the tag titles they hold.
Sacrilege! Sacrilege! You know how much work the Death Squad put into actually constructing and making those belts out of pure Sheffield steel? They slaved for weeks over those belts, and yet these two just cast them aside like that.
And Steve, here's a little bit of a scoop for you. Here's a little bit of history. Paul Terrell used to be a former tag team partner of none other than Ultimate Wrestling Alliance television champion Flying Phil Powers.
I hate him! Get out! Well done, ref.
Of course, Phil may not be the television champion after next week, where he puts the title back on the line against Hot Stuff Stevie Knight.
Well, as I said before, Ross, we saw Stevie Knight earlier, and indeed we saw Phil Powers. And Stevie Knight, I am convinced, will be the new TV champion. There's no doubt in my mind about that one. Of course, that's next week. And already this evening, to look forward to, we've got Drew McDonald up against Doug Williams as he defends his UWA Heavyweight title.
Exactly. The big one. The big one. It's the UWA World title. And I'm looking so forward to that match. I think Doug Williams will probably win, but that's just because I like him a bit more. Drew McDonald has Steve Linsky, and we all know about Steve Linsky's tactics and what a force Drew McDonald is to be reckoned with, as we saw him beat Danny Royal to take the number one contendership for the UWA World title.
That fight is going to be payback. That is going to be payback.
You know, we've talked about the change of attitude, and it's what I've said about a few wrestlers. You don't have to like their attitude, but you must respect their ability, as we see a great missile dropkick off the top rope from Paul Terrell. That's, of course, a maneuver that his former tag team partner Phil Powers also used.
I hate him.
And of course, in 2 weeks' time, we'll see Too Far Gone back in the ring as a unit defending their tag team titles against the number one contenders for those belts, which of course is the Death Squad. And it won't just be the belts which are on the line, it will be the Death Squad's bikes.
One, two, three, four, five.
You know, Ross, I'm a patriot and everything else, but even I have to salute the power of the Viking here.
Come on, Paul!
He's gone about attempting to conquer the British boy, Paul Tyrrell, but there is a lot of power there. And you see it go down like that. The bigger they are, the harder they fall, as they say.
You've got to wonder if Paul Tyrrell is a little bit rusty in terms of singles competition.
Did you see him fly out of there?
Onto the hard floor. As I was saying, you've got to wonder. Oh, that's got to hurt.
Oh, my God. Hold on. That spectator's nearly as fat as the Viking. Get him in the ring. Yeah, Paul Tyrrell's fighting the wrong bloke.
You're obviously missing the point, Steve. Wrestlers need talent. Wrestlers need wrestling ability to get in the ring. Not anyone can just step through those ropes. But as I was saying, I'll finally get it out. Do you think that Paul Tyrrell is perhaps a little bit rusty? He's been competing for so long in tag team matches. He hasn't been involved in a singles match for quite some time, and certainly not involved in one in the UWA. But what's Paul Tyrrell going for now? He lifts the Viking to the top rope. A few punches stuns the Viking. And watch this. This could be a terrific maneuver. I think he's going for a hurricanrana off the top rope. Oh, my God.
Viewers, I can tell you now that Ross the Boss has just passed out. He's foaming at the mouth with excitement over that move. I've never seen a young man in such a deep state of joy.
But come on, let's be serious. Look at it again. That is a beautiful technical aerial move. Superb wrestling. Anyone who is a wrestling fan has to appreciate what they're seeing in the ring. Superb action. I'm proud to be part of this promotion.
We've got more of a match coming up pretty soon. Drew McDonald against the anarchist, Doug Williams.
Too Far Gone have their first title defence in just 2 weeks' time. Right now, however, all eyes are on the anarchist. Will he still be the UWA champion after this encounter with Drew McDonald? We certainly know that Doug Williams is a tough competitor. In the Triple Trouble match, Knight and Cabrero threw pretty much everything they had at him, and Doug still came out victorious. However, when Drew McDonald called Doug out just a couple of weeks ago, the wily Highlander drew first blood, reopening that ugly head injury sustained in the Triple Trouble match. Has the anarchist recovered sufficiently? We're about to find out.
Drew McDonald, title match is coming up, and I'm going to beat you like a dog.
It's time for the world title match to take place. And out first is going to be the challenger, Drew McDonald, with his manager, a man I don't like, Steve Linsky.
You may not like him, but you've got to respect him.
Hey, that's my line.
Well, I've been working with you for too long now, Ross. I've even started to dress like you. What do you make of this kilt? Ha-ha! I joke, of course. But we can hear the man now! Steve Linsky! Accompanied by Drew McDonald.
I'm scared sitting in the commentary booth watching this wrestler. His legs are like tree trunks. Here we see how Drew McDonald won this title shot by besting Danny Royal. Steve Linsky removed the turnbuckle.
I have something to say. Better to button up.
Rock on!
Anarchist, I have a message for you. The demons that lurk deep in my head demand a sacrifice. And you, Anarchist, will be that sacrifice. We are going to take you to the other side, brother. And you had better get on your knees and pray to your stinking Nazarene God to save your soul, because your body belongs to us.
What the hell is he saying?
Well, you're Scottish, you must understand it, but this is how Doug Williams became a man alone in the UWA when he booted his manager Steve Linsky out of the ring.
I mean, here's the anarchist, great as he is, but I'm shocked by what I just heard Drew McDonald say. He said his body belonged to who? And what God? I can't make any sense of this. I'm scared just sitting here.
Well, he's probably your next door neighbour in Glasgow or wherever you're from. You must be able to understand what he's on about. It's me who has trouble.
I'm from Royal Stirling, and he certainly doesn't live next door to me.
Well, it's not a big place, is it, Scotland? He's probably a neighbour.
I'll ignore those comments. Now we're going to see a great match here. The talking is done. The action will begin. Drew McDonald is a super heavyweight. The man possesses muscles where people just normally don't have muscles. And as great an athlete as Doug Williams is, he certainly can battle the power game against Drew McDonald.
Well, Drew McDonald also knows Doug Williams' Achilles heel. Remember the head injury he sustained in the Triple Trouble match, which Drew went for, and I think he's going to go for again in this contest.
We see now the anarchist applying a side headlock, but Drew McDonald just brushes the anarchist off and once again knocks him down to the canvas. Doug ran into Drew. Drew hardly flinched, and Doug hit hard on the ground. But now Doug gets a comeback. A superb back body drop. Gets a one, gets a two. Almost a near fall. A near fall, nearly scoring the pinfall victory early on.
It's a great contest. There's more to come,
one,
people,
two.
After the break.
Live TV spotlights the fashion world as they strut their stuff in Paris. The Fashion Show in 15 minutes.
Don't try this with an ordinary pen. It's the Penali fountain pen. The secret's in the nib. This amazing pen features a unique iridium tip nib, specially crafted and constructed with Swiss precision engineering. It's hard, it's durable, it's virtually indestructible. Plus, you can choose to use the removable pump or the disposable cartridge. Because it's pressure sensitive, it adjusts to your own writing style. And unlike ordinary fountain pens, Penali writes in all directions, just like a ball pen. The amazing Penali pen. Excellent performance, first time, every time. And it's yours for only $19.95, plus postage and packing of $4.95. But that's not all. To promote this exciting range of pens, you'll also receive the complete set of matching Penali pens as a special bonus. You'll receive the executive ball pen with a pressurized refill system. Next, the reliable rollerball. It writes on practically any surface, even upside down. Next, the Penali combi pen. It writes blue, twisted, writes green, and now red. And it's yours. Also, this fabulous ladies' pen, perfectly balanced. It's elegant and stylish to pop into your handbag. You'll also get this matching mechanical pencil that writes and draws smoothly. Plus, we'll also throw in this bonus super slim checkbook pen. But wait, there's more. You'll also get this 65-piece refill pack as an extra bonus. Solve all your gift problems for just $19.95 plus postage and packing of $4.95. Call the number on your screen now to order your Penali pen set today. Operators are standing by to take your order.
Take a fun look into your future with the help of the tarot cards. Call 08962-626201 and let the cards help guide you in all aspects of your life. If you're more interested in your love life, call 08962-626202 for a relationship reading. Or why not consult the stars to find out just who is your ideal astrological partner? Call now on 08962-626203.
This week on Mismatch of the Day.
So I'm up against the monster schmuck there, I call. My job's right on the line here. I've got to beat him today.
You were useless.
A war of words and money on Mismatch of the Day. And
ain't nothing but a hound dog.
Elvis back from the dead on Mismatch of the Day this week.
Hi there, fans. You're joining us just as the action is starting to heat up. As we see Doug Williams now on the outside and taking a terrible beating against a guardrail from the Highlander, Drew McDonald.
What I'm wondering, Ross, is whether or not Steve Linsky is going to get a few sly punches in as well.
I'm just waiting for that to happen. I'm not wondering. I'm just waiting. Doug Williams' beating from Drew McDonald is systematic. He's being taken down bone by bone, structure by structure in his body. He's worked on his head. He's now working on his back. How long before he goes to work on his legs?
I will say this for Doug, though. We know he can take a lot of punishment after seeing him in that triple trouble match. We know he can take it.
Oh, my
God, and he can dish it out as well.
Look at that, a tremendous suplex on
the outside. Let's take another look at that, Ross, my son, because it was superb.
That's going to hurt Drew McDonald. Look at the power exhibited by the anarchist. That man is a monster. He is an absolute monster. He makes me wonder if he really is a human being at all with what he was talking about.
Well, he's a Scotsman, so I don't know if that counts.
He's well-bred, certainly. Well-bred. And the anarchist, it's... Oh, my God!
Oh, my word!
Did you see that? A cross-body block sent both men crashing to the outside, over the top rope and down onto that hard surface. What do we have here? Oh, this could be dangerous. This could be brutal. That could put Doug Williams out of the sport. If he has landed badly there, yeah, that could be Doug Williams out of the sport. If he's landed well, he's going to be in tremendous pain. But if he's landed badly, I fear a referee should be stopping this. The match can't continue. He's just been powerbombed on the outside. For the love of God, have some respect and stop the match. This is horrible.
Oh, my God. Doug Williams now, as I said before, is the loner in the UWA. And never has he felt so alone right now up against Drew McDonald.
Doug Williams cannot defend himself. He's been beaten from pillar to post.
I told from, you.
From hard.
Only one!
Drew McDonald!
What on earth was that?
Drew McDonald has been bust open now. There's blood in this match. Oh my. Stop
There's
the ref!
There's blood and not much diction!
Stop the match, referee! This is sick. This isn't a match. This has gone beyond the match. Doug Williams is out. He's out. Look. He's barely moving. A side slam, this is it. One, two. Oh my! Doug Williams kicks out at the very last moment.
Shaking his head there. He's thinking, what does it take? What does it take to put this man down to win this contest? I think there is respect there for what Doug Williams is taking, the punishment, the beating that Doug Williams is taking from Drew McDonald.
He should be submitting, but he has too much heart. He has too much courage. He's got too much fight in him to know when to
quit.
But
Steve Linsky will have told Drew McDonald not to underestimate this man. Having managed him for so long, he knows, he's well aware of the beating and the pounding that he can take. And the fact that he's capable of coming back from seemingly nowhere to win a fight. So Steve Linsky, I know as a great manager, would have told Drew, just don't underestimate him.
What we are seeing here is the ability that is required to be a world heavyweight champion. It doesn't take coming in the ring and doing silly poses. It doesn't take getting on the mic and shouting your mouth off. It takes pure wrestling ability and fight. Fight in your soul, in your spirit, and in your body. And that's what being a world heavyweight champion is all about in this sport. And I say it again, this is not a joke, a Saturday morning cartoon. This is a sport. and we are seeing two of the greatest athletes exhibit their tenacity in the ring. Surely this must be it if Drew McDonald sits this.
Ross, here comes the pain! Here comes the pain!
Two, three, no! No, only two! Steve Linsky looks in shock. Steve Linsky looks in shock.
Well, Ross, you know, I've been a big fan, a big supporter of Steve Linsky, but even there, I saw on his face the sheer disbelief in his eyes. Even he didn't think that Doug Williams could stand for all this.
Drew McDonald now ascends to the top rope. He thinks he's going to take it up to another level, but no! No, the Anarchist is back on his feet! I can't believe this! The Anarchist is back on his feet, hitting a huge superplex off the top rope! A huge superplex, getting tremendous elevation! One, two! Drew McDonald kicks out! What will it take to put either of these individuals down? I thought Doug Williams was finished, but it could be Drew McDonald finished now as Doug Williams hits his pain-indeed German suplex for the one for the two. Steve Linsky had no right interfering there, and Doug is now shouting at Linsky. But look, Drew McDonald's taken down the turnbuckle pad.
No, it fell down. It was an accident.
It fell down by the hands of Drew McDonald as he hits another powerbomb.
Well, you get in there and tell
him
that.
Here comes Danny Royal, the beef man. The beef man.
What is he doing here?
He went
and he's
Drew
still
McDonald
got those raggedy old, he's still got those raggedy trunks on.
And as I move salt, this could be it. Turn round, referee. One, two, three. That's it. Doug Williams successfully defends his title as Danny Royal came in and got his receipt. His receipt on the Highlander. He exposed the turnbuckle, the Highlander himself.
Danny Royal! Danny Royal should be kicked out of the UWA!
I want to have another look at that. Let's see what happens again. Here we see Danny Royal hitting the ring. Then a great Irish whip sends Drew McDonald into the exposed turnbuckle of pure steel. And then it left Doug Williams to hit the Acai moonsault to get the pinfall cover, and I'm losing my voice because
that was an absolute outrage. And as I said before, Danny Royal, shame, shame, shame.
It just goes to show, nothing beats the chaos theory. And although Danny Royal, you came down and you did your bit here in the ring, it doesn't matter because I'll have beaten him anyway. Because I am the UWA champion. As far as I am that, anarchy's going to rule in the UWA.
Anarchy certainly is prevailing in the UWA to round off another jam-packed, action-filled show. What a show we have just witnessed. And more to the point, what a title defense Doug Williams has just done.
Don't forget, next week, we've got Stevie Knight up against Phil Powers. Join us!
For more information on the Ultimate Wrestling Alliance, call the UWA hotline on 0660 020 009. Calls cost 50p a minute, and you must have permission from whoever pays the bill before calling. Or you can write or email us at the address on your screen.